Hi guys, this is Lillo, sales manager from Mackma. Welcome to our showroom. We want to show you how to work with this machine, so let's see how to mount first the tooling and after we show you how to bend. Let's see how to put the tools on the machine. We will put the roller, the counter bending die and cleese to the bending die. Let's start. This is the counter bending die I'm using. An Amco counter bending die. This is in order to avoid the scratches on the surface for the stainless steel tube. Totally closing, and then I turn back one round. This is very important because this counter bending die needs to slide, so there's a spring inside and it needs to move in this way. So this is okay. And now we put the roller. So 1¼ inch. So put this, and with a 5mm Allen key, we just turn the screw inside, so it's okay. Let's put the bending die. I turn a little bit back that I have more space. So this is our die, 1¼ inch, radius 85. It's a special tooling because the bending radius is very small. This is our tube, so it's a stainless steel, 1¼ by 3mm wall thickness. Very important is also that when you are going to clamp the pipe, you need to push this lever totally to the end and try to leave this straight when you are going forward to clamp the pipe. Yeah, he will adjust himself the position. Yeah, this is exactly what we want. And when you are clamping the pipe, you see the gap here between the groove and the pipe. So you are going to fix the pipe since you have about 5mm gap. Yeah, between 5-6mm gap. So I will go a little bit more forward. It depends also on the bending radius and on the wall thickness what we have for this pipe. Right now we are using 1¼ inch with 3mm wall, so that's okay. So this gap is normal, yeah? It doesn't mean that we need to go totally inside also, because we will be not able to put the pipe totally inside the groove. It will be the machine, when we start to bend, to bring the pipe inside. So we need normally really big force to put the pipe inside, but it's not necessary, the machine will do the rest. Let's see how to bend. Now we go back to zero, we reached our 90 degree without spring back, and with the foot pedal I push now back. Well, now I remove the pipe, what is still without spring back, in order that we can measure the angle. Yeah, as you can see, it's not a 90 degree because we don't have inserted the spring back. Let's see how many degrees it is. 122.9, so it means around 33 degrees of spring back. This we will put now inside the machine. So I push the arrow down in order to go in this field, push enter. And with the arrow up, I will put here my spring back of the material. Oops. As I told you, when you hold on, it goes very fast. So we will put here 33 degrees. Let's see how to finish the bend. The advantage is that I can still use this bend. That means I insert the bend without the spring back, move the counter bending die to my position, And I can continue to finish the spent now, yeah? This is a big advantage. Let's go. So, a 90 degree bend. Thank you very much for watching our webinar. We finished today. Further questions or clarification, you can send me an email on info@mackma.com. Thank you. See you on the next video. Bye bye.